What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Ray the Rookie back at it again. Just a noob trying to get some experience points. And today, we're going to do some. I'm going to tell you a story. It's story time Sunday, so you know what time it is. It's time to educate y'all, you know? If you try to make it personal, try to make you guys know who I am. So, basically, like the title says, I'm going to talk about how I got into gaming. Where did it all begin? And I got some Monster Hunter gameplay for you in the background, rocking that Agenath armor and flame, you know, great sword. Don't worry, the Agenath video is coming out soon. Next is I have the Baroth that's coming out tomorrow, and don't worry, he's gonna be there soon. Anyway, so let's get to the story. So, growing up, being that I'm from in the Caribbean household. My dad was a sci-fi nerd. He loved everything sci-fi. He loved, you know, Star Trek, all that. But he also loved video games. He loved the graphics. He loved the design. He loved everything about it. So, you know, it's not surprising that me and my brother, we fell into video game, to gaming, you know. It was meant to happen. So, I remember the first game he ever downloaded for us on PC. So, I originally started as a PC gamer, was damn, if I only can remember the name. It was like this Metal Slug. Sorry, yeah, Metal Slug. Like, I remember playing that game because it used to be in the laundromat where we used to go do laundry when we lived in Brooklyn. And he got it on our computer, and I was like, whoa, I didn't know games could go on computers. It was like a whole new world for me, you know? So, just seeing that was pretty awesome, you know? So, basically, from there, you know, I remember he bought me my first Game Boy Advance. And I'm not talking about, like, the skinny, long ones. I'm talking about the fat one. Like, the Game Boy, the fat, round ones. And I remember the first game I ever got was Wario Land 4. And boy, did I love that game. Because it was just crazy. You had time limit to beat the level. You had this. It was so many things that you had to account for, and me being a young kid, I had no idea what was going on. I was just trying to get these diamonds to fight these bosses who were extremely hard for a kid to verse, but you didn't give up. You kept doing it because you wanted to win. But I would say the true moment when I understood what gaming really was when I first saw that Kingdom Hearts 2 commercial. Boy, that Kingdom Hearts 2 commercial was so beautiful. Hikara, why can't I say her name? Yeah, she sang, Sanctuary. Boy, did that resonate with me. And at the time, I don't know if it was Roxas, but my man was running on. I saw people running on fire. I saw Donald Goofy fighting. I saw this kid named Sora. It was just action-packed, you know? And this is me as a kid, like, oh my God, what is this? And then I remember me and my dad both watched it, and we saw, like, the scar scene. We saw, like, we were like, whoa, this is great. We gotta get it. And I, like, after a while, I forgot about it because, you know, it came out. It came out like in March or something. No. That, you know, the time I saw the commercial was definitely in, I want to say, it was like in the midsummer I saw that commercial, and I forgot about it. So that year, that Christmas, my dad bought us, because we had a PlayStation 2 at the time, and he bought us a Digimon Data Squad. I will never forget that. And guess what else was there? Kingdom Hearts 2. Boy, was I late. I'm like, oh man, I gotta play this game. I gotta beat this game. I gotta platinum this game. You know what I'm saying? And it was then I really understood what it meant to platinum a game or what it meant to play a game. Because, like, you had this intricate story of this young boy trying to find his place in the world. Right? And these guys around him are not, like, they say they're for him, but they're not. And they just want to use him. And it made me think about, like, my life, and I'm like, why do I relate to Sora? Why do I relate to Roxas, like, not knowing who I am? And at the time, I was in middle school, high school, era. So, like, you know, going through that whole grown up phase, not knowing who you are, trying to fit in. And video games became like an outlet for me, you know what I'm saying? A lot of my friends play video games, the Call of Duties, the, you know, God of War era, you know what I'm saying? And it was just beautiful to me that I was able to, you know, meet a lot of friends, a lot of people through video games because we had this understanding. You know, a lot of my friends played Kingdom Hearts. I remember Dragon Ball Z was thrown out of game every year, from Budokai 1 to 3 to Tenkaichi. And I just remember playing all of them with my friends, like having birthday parties, inviting them over. We just verse each other and just, and that's all we needed. We didn't need to, you know, drink, do alcohol, you know, drugs or anything. We just played video games. We just ordered pizza, friends came over, and I, you know, we just played games. And, you know, video games became a very important part to me because, you know, my dad, he would always buy us a game. He would come in and like, oh, let me play with you guys. He would always try to play the fighting games, but he could never win, man. It was always funny. But, yeah, man. It's just like video games is just this thing. Like, just this platform where you can meet so many cool people and you can just, you know, everyone has this understanding, like, yeah, like, when Aerith died in Final Fantasy VII, we all felt that pain that Cloud felt. Or when we just felt powerful when we were smashing in God's faces with Kratos. It's just like, video games became like an outlet for a lot of people, and it did for me, too. If you look at my PlayStation Network, a lot of people, like, I know today that are my friends, I met through PlayStation, or I met through, you know, going to like video game conventions or, you know, anime conventions, and it's just a beautiful thing. Like this whole issue with the whole mental health, like you have like people being addicted. Yeah, I think there's a limit to everything, but I think people are failing to understand that the real issue is, why do people play video games? Why do you play video games? I know for me, the reason why I play video games is because I enjoy, like, you know, doing something where I can save people, or I can help people, or just that I just need a group. I can meet good people and just have a good time and just socialize and have fun. That's why I play video games. I play because, you know, I connect with a lot of people. A lot of my friends are international, or, you know, are in different states, so I don't really get to see them every day. So, like, playing video games, I get to talk to them. I get to communicate with them, whereas, like, normally I wouldn't be able to see them. And we all can reminisce about funny moments where we're versing a monster hunter, and we just get destroyed. Or as simple as, like, yo, did you reach the part in Final Fantasy 15 where, you know, this happened? We get to share these moments, even though we're not too close, like, together, like, in the same room, you know? And I think that's why I really started gaming, because it helped me make friends and it helped me figure out who I am. Like, I tell people, like, yo, Kingdom Hearts changed my life. Like, people don't understand. Like, Kingdom Hearts really did change my life. It showed me that, you know, not everyone that we think is bad. Like, it had that effect on me where it just made me want to be a better person. And it made me like a dreamer and a creative person I am today. Because, like, imagine as a kid, right? You grow up your whole life, and you just sit into these stigmas of, you know, what society tells you you have to be. And then you play these games, and you see these heroes basically telling society, go screw yourself. You know, and you see, like, the main character just saying no to what the, you know, their oppressors are trying to force on them. And it gives you this kind of modicum of, like strength, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, they were able to overcome their oppressors, why can't I? You know, and that's what video games did to me, you know? And honestly, if I ever had to give advice to people, I would say, do I regret playing video games? No. Not at all. I think it helped me, like, be as creative and be as outspoken as I am now. And, like, I do these videos more so for you guys. And a little bit for myself, because I enjoy, like, the whole process of editing. I enjoy learning something new. So being able to, like, you know, make these videos and show people, like, my skills, and be able to say, like, show my kids one day, look, your dad used to do this back in the day, you know? Granted, if I don't ever become famous like you, like, I always look back and thank video game for, you know, helping me open up, for helping me be the better person I am. And I'm glad that my father started me on Warrior World, or he got me into video games, and he always supported me, you know, through it. So I guess, you know, that's really it, you know. I started video games to meet people, and I've met so many great people, and I just did it to enter a fantasy world where I can just dictate the choices, or I can dictate how things go, and, you know, give me a sense of control. And I feel like that's what video games do for a lot of people. Give them a sense of fulfillment, you know. It's just something to do, you know. So this is really why I play video games, you know. And I guarantee a lot of you feel the same way. So this is story time. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And you know, you come back and so like and subscribe, because, you know, at the end of the day, I do this for you guys. Be it 10, 5, 25, whatever. I don't care how big or how small the number is. I'm just glad that I'm able to, you know, get my voice out there and just, you know, maybe inspire somebody somewhere to do something like this. So this is Ray the Rookie. I hope you enjoyed my story. And you just earned some experience points. Peace.